In the East, Jason Kidd and the New Jersey Nets were making their own run to the finals.
Kidd starts to make his move, 6 seconds. Kidd driving right of the lane, goes baseline right, fadeaway jumper, around and in! Jason Kidd with a clutch shot from the right baseline.
With 10 straight playoff wins, the Nets also earned a shot at redemption, a year after being swept by the Lakers.
They are the back-to-back NBA Eastern Conference champions for the second straight year.
This year, unlike last year, we're not just happy to get there. You know, we feel we can win a championship with what we have right here.
Good evening and welcome to Game 1. It's the New Jersey Nets, the number 2 seed from the East, against the San Antonio Spurs, the number 1 seed from the West.
The team's ready. We're loose. The Greyhounds are ready to get out and do some running.
A couple miles of tape there.
I'm playing for one thing. I brought this out. This was my first. Once you win this, there's nobody that can take it away from you. Stand in front of these guys. You're going to let them know we're here right from the tip. Right from the tip.
Hey, man, somebody got to do it, baby.
This is the first time the two former outstanding ABA franchises have ever come together. In fact, the doctor, Julius Erving and George Gervin, will be out there for the ceremonial opening toss.
And once the finals tipped off, it didn't take long for New Jersey to take command.
The tap controlled by Kidd. Jump with the first shot is in, and the Nets quickly jump ahead by a deuce. Power attack on the right. The jump shot is on the money. The Nets, they are razor sharp. Here comes Kidd, looking for that fast break. The Spurs are back. Picking up the Kittles. Here comes this three. Good. And everything, folks, is breaking New Jersey's way. 27 for Duncan. San Antonio closing in on a game one victory. Going to the whip. This was never in doubt since early in the third quarter.
You know, they have the MVP, and, you know, he played like that tonight.
But as San Antonio looked to deliver the early knockout, New Jersey would answer with a counterpunch of their own, and it came from their superstar, Jason Kidd. Just as Tim Duncan had dominated Game 1 for the Spurs, Kidd was now putting his own stamp on Game 2 while putting the Nets on his shoulders.
And Jason Kidd suddenly became Jason Kidd. Woo! Oh, crossover on Duncan. Kidd weaves through everybody and scores.
He is putting on a historical level performance.
A tough shot rolls in for Jason Kidd. 58-45.
Biggest lead of the night, biggest lead of the series for New Jersey.
The Kidd had been finding the answers all night, and now he would find one more.
New Jersey's up only a point. Here comes Kidd. Drives hard. Tough shot. Yes!
It seemed to be the final dagger.
They won it. They win it on the road. 87-85, and it's going back to the Meadowlands at a game apiece.
Back to New Jersey. 1-1.
Hey, we broke our streak. We broke our streak.
The scene has shifted east for the next three games between the New Jersey Nets and the San Antonio Spurs. But after their dramatic win in Game 2, the Nets are determined to hold serve at home.
There'll be no kidding around in Game 3. Jason Kidd is the real MVP.
Tim Duncan, bye-bye.
Prepare to lose, Duncan.
Nets are going to win.
You're going down.
Are you ready?
Energized by the crowd and their defense, the Nets would grab the early lead.
Martin takes it away from him. High pick and roll, and they've turned it over off of it. Here comes Kittles. Beautiful two-handed slam on the pass from Jason Kidd. 30 has tied the finals record.
While both teams had been shackled on offense, the Nets would finally break free in the third quarter.
Kidd, what a pass to Jefferson. Have snatched it right back after losing by two in Game 2 on their home floor at SBC Center. They come back and beat the Nets here in New Jersey.
From the start, Richard Jefferson would give the Nets the lift they so desperately needed.
Jefferson attacks! Two-handed slam from Richard Jefferson. Oh! Richard Jefferson! Get out of the way!
That is a throwdown.
Airball put back at the buzzer. That'll do it. So New Jersey holds on to win it.
Welcome to Game 5 of the NBA Finals 2003. The Nets and the San Antonio Spurs all deadlocked at 2-2. Tonight, a sold-out crowd for the biggest game in Nets franchise history.
A lot of energy, baby. Keep that same intensity that we had the last game. Let's just take it up another notch.
And in this pivotal game, New Jersey would come out ready.
Kid turns baseline, jump shot, good over Parker.
Well, that's a terrific sign for New Jersey. And a steal by Kittles. Coast to coast for Kittles. Look out.
It was clear that the Nets were playing with a sense of desperation.
He's out of bounds. Stop. T. Right here.
Byron, I am trying to be patient with you. I understand what the game is about.
Jefferson to Kidd. Kidd, pull-up jumper. He's feeling it. Watch out.
Trailing by 8 points at halftime, the Nets would look to their leader to bring them back.
Ducking in too far, loses the handle. Jefferson comes back, three on two again. Bowen quickly back, and Kidd hits a three-footer in the lane. Nets for the lead this time. Kidd post, Claxton got it on the turnaround from 13 feet. Jason Kidd puts the Nets ahead, 50-49 here.
I know they're getting back, you know, two or three guys. He's pushing. We still need you guys to run.
With the Spurs about to put the game away, the Nets would suddenly break loose for one final run.
Jefferson throws it in. Jason Kidd to Jefferson. Inside, Jefferson scores. That's going to be Duncan.
Jefferson's driving layup has made it 78-76.
After playing just 2 minutes the entire series, Steve Kerr would step in to face an inspired Nets team, a frenzied crowd, and a critical situation.
They load Duncan. You give it back. Here comes Stevie's three ball. Yes! Stevie Kerr! Now Martin back to the basket. Desperate. Bad pass. Ginobili. Gonna try to run it out. Keeps coming. Layups. Good! For Ginobili on the steal. Now here comes Parker off the dribble, a high pick and roll into Kerr in the corner. Kerr, the pull-up 17-footer off the dribble. Steve Kerr, oh my!
Once again, Kerr had delivered when the Spurs needed him most.
I love it!
So San Antonio is going to take it home to Texas with a chance on Sunday to win the NBA championship.
Again, Richard Jefferson and the Nets would look to crash David Robinson's retirement party.
Off now quickly to Kidd. Kidd whips it over to a cutting Jefferson for the layup. What a brilliant play that time.
And it's all New Jersey right now.
Kenyon Martin long range. Jefferson hammers it home.
The Richard Jefferson show is in full flight here.
The lead is double figures for the Nets.
But as they had done so many times before, the tandem of Duncan and Robinson would carry the Spurs.
Cuts to the free throw line, back to Tim inside, off the Robinson slam dunk.
And with the game in danger of slipping away early, they would battle to keep San Antonio within striking distance.
He's going to take it inside, Duncan loses the ball, picks it back up, shot off the side of the backboard, gets the offensive rebound, puts up a shot, scores, and he is fouled. He went up strong that time and showed some emotion.
Could be the play to get him back in the game.
But every time the Spurs got close, the Nets would pull away once again. Leading by 9 points midway through the fourth quarter, New Jersey was in total command.
Here's a scoop for all you Spurs fans. The Nets aren't going away.
And it was starting to seem as if a seventh game was inevitable.
Nets are in deep trouble here. Kenyon Martin trying to hold his ground. They kick it back. Jackson going again. He's got it. He's hit three consecutive three balls.
And the Spurs now in a 19-0 run, and they're pulling away. They lead by 10.
It's all falling apart for the Nets. The Spurs can almost smell it.
Claxton splits the D, loses it, and Robinson is there again. Claxton's 15-footer. Yeah, baby. Get the champagne ready, baby. The Admiral ship is coming in.
The San Antonio Spurs are NBA world champions.